Guess we can begin. So, welcome everybody to Lesnar High School. As you guys are probably aware, the rules quickly, we'll play 30-minute matches, the first of which will be between Uxbridge to my right, correct? Yes. All right, we're rolling. And Lester to my left.
Yeah.
Woo!
Not necessary. Relish the underdog role, guys, relish that role. I will ask a toss-up question, which is a question that must be answered by just one teammate, a team member. If a team rings in and answers that question correctly, that team will have an opportunity to answer a bonus question, which will rotate between 2, 3, and 4 parts, and 10 points for each of these questions based on the correct answers. The bonus questions can be questions that more than one team member works on. If a team answers incorrectly, then the other team will have an opportunity to answer. Again, there is no conferring on toss-up questions, but teams may indeed confer on bonus questions. Teams will have about 30 seconds to confer on bonus questions, and time will be called after a toss-up question if no one has rang in after 10 seconds-ish. Okay, rules clear? Very good, then I believe we can begin with our first toss-up question. And I will try to keep the buzzer. Okay, here we go. Name the countries that are Finland's neighbors to the east and to the west. Uxbridge.
Sweden and Switzerland?
That is incorrect. I'm sorry, I have a point of clarification. Toss-ups, they don't have a chance to answer, do they? Oh, you can? Okay. So it goes right to a bonus?
No.
Okay, so you can answer if you want. Yeah. Thank you.
Sweden and Russia?
Sweden and Russia are correct. Okay, the first bonus question, which is just for Lester, is a two-part question worth a total of 10 points for each correct answer. Identify the following noteworthy personalities by the labels most often prefixed to their names. Welsh poet. Yeah. Pass, thank you. Greek shipping magnate. Yeah, we didn't get the easy box on that one. Okay. Okay, all right. Okay. Would that have mattered? Yeah, it didn't. The correct answers are Welsh poet Dylan Thomas and the Greek shipping magnate was Aristotle Onassis. Yeah, okay. Again, thank you for that. Probably didn't matter that time. All right. So, toss-up question number 2. Both teams are on playing here. I will define 4 words. Each uses the same letters the same number of times, but in different arrangements. Identify all 4 of these words. Okay, ready? Same letters, same number of times, but in different places. A, makes a clear profit. B, a number, plural. C, dispatched. And D, a bird's home. Going once, twice, 3 times. Okay, next question. The answer, by the way, was makes a clear profit, nets, a number plural, tens, dispatched, sent, and of course a bird's home is a nest. Okay, next toss-up question. Again, both teams here. Name the European cathedral that was destroyed in 1194, rebuilt in 1220, and is considered the first of the high Gothic buildings. Uxbridge.
The Sistine Chapel?
That is incorrect.
Notre Dame Cathedral?
That is also incorrect. Correct answer is Chartres Cathedral. Okay, toss-up question. Again, both teams. Every piece of U.S. paper money carries this statement. Quote, this note is blank for all debts, public and private, unquote. Fill in the blank. Going once, twice, Uxbridge.
Ballot.
That is incorrect. Once, twice. The answer is legal tender. Okay, next toss-up question. Again, both teams. What word best describes the style in which the French composers Ravel and Debussy composed? Lester.
Romantic.
That is incorrect, but thank you for saying that word. Uxbridge.
Classical?
It's a good guess. Incorrect. The correct answer is impressionist. Moving on. Toss-up question. Both teams. In this city, you can visit the American Banjo Museum in Bricktown, the Museum of Osteology, and the National Cowboy and Western Heritage Museum. The only Capitol building in the world that has a producing oil well under it is found in what U.S. city? Lester.
Nashville?
Nashville is incorrect. Uxbridge.
Austin?
Austin is also incorrect. The correct answer is Oklahoma City. In Oklahoma. Get it? Next toss-up question, both teams. Who hit the top 10 album chart more than anyone in pop music history with 84 albums? Lester.
Elvis Presley.
The answer is correct. And smooth, by the way. Okay, we have a bonus question now for Lester, and this is a three-part bonus question, and I will read the entire question and give you guys a little bit of time to answer all parts. Here we go. Just kidding. Okay, here we go. For 10 points apiece, sorry, these expressions refer to two rhyming words. For example, if I said drawing off the intellectual elite, your answer would be brain drain. So, for 10 points apiece, the expressions I'll be saying refer to two rhyming words. Drawing off the intellectual elite, your answer would be brain drain. So the three things you have to answer are the following. A, difficult, untrimmed fairway. B, more evil malediction. C, first-rate confection. You have 30 seconds-ish. More evil malediction and first-rate confection.
First one, tough, rough.
That is correct.
Yeah!
They're on time, guys. Hold the applause, please. They're on time. 10 seconds? All right, fair enough. More evil malediction is a worse curse, and the first rate confection is dandy candy, which can be found in the snack shop. All right, back to a toss-up question for both teams again. What was the standard weapon of the British infantry from the late 13th century until 1595? Lester.
The longbow?
Longbow is correct.
Yes!
Okay, four-part bonus question. Again, you can't confirm this. I'll read the entire question. And the values are 10 points apiece. It's a tricky to read, too. Okay, the subject of this is seven-letter words, and I will read a definition, and you will name the word. And again, I'll give all four of these to you at the same time. You can confer for 30 seconds, and we can have answers. So again, subject is seven-letter words. A, name the depressant drug that causes about 50% of highway deaths. B, what term describes soil which is rich in minerals for growing crops? C, what name is given to the electrochemical message passed along a nerve? And D, what name is given to the fine colored powder that when combined with various liquid mixtures makes paint? 30 seconds.
The messaging one, is that synapse?
I'll take all of your answers.
Oh, I know. Okay.
Yeah, Leo.
Wait.
10 seconds. Can I get a final answer, please?
Is the first one, was that the drug one?
Correct.
The cocaine?
That is incorrect.
The second one was the soil one? No.
No is incorrect. Two letters.
What was the next one?
Electrochemical message.
Synapse?
That is incorrect.
And we don't know the other one either.
Okay, all right. Reese, that's an easy one to score. You can stay right there. Correct answers. The depressant drug was alcohol, the soil was fertile, the electrochemical message is impulse, and the fine colored powder when mixed with various liquid mixtures that makes paint is a pigment. Okay, all right, so we're back to the toss-up questions. And the score currently Leicester at 40, Uxbridge at nil. Okay, toss-up question. What is the most abundant mineral in the body? Uxbridge.
What is carbon?
Carbon is incorrect.
Calcium.
Calcium is correct. Okay, bonus question. Now this will be a two-part. And you may recognize a trend, 2, 3, 4, back to 2. Okay, so for Leicester, plays are usually divided into sections. What are the major divisions called in a play? And what are further divisions called? So two types of divisions in plays. 30 seconds.
Go with acts and intermissions.
Acts is correct. Intermissions is not. Yep, you get 10 points for the correct answer. The second correct answer is scenes. Scenes. Okay, both teams, toss-up question. What word did most people answer the telephone with when it was first introduced at the end of the 19th century? Uxbridge.
Hello?
That is incorrect. But a pretty good guess. Last one.
Good evening.
Also a good guess, also incorrect. The correct answer was ahoy. Yeah, I hate, listen, I'm not writing these. In fact, I don't even know any of them. Okay, toss-up question, both teams on. Henry Hudson, the Englishman, explored the area around the Hudson River in 1609 for what company? Going once. Uxbridge.
British East India?
That is incorrect. 5 seconds, Lester? The correct answer is Dutch East India Company. Very close. Very close. Toss-up question, both teams. The Red Shirts and the Red Brigades are associated with Italy. With what country would you link the Red Guards? Oxbridge.
Britain.
Britain is incorrect. Lester.
Turkey.
Turkey is also incorrect. Correct answer is China. Okay, toss-up question, both teams. The inhabitants of this island, although U.S. citizens, neither pay federal taxes nor vote in national elections. Oxbridge.
Puerto Rico.
Puerto Rico is correct. Okay, bonus question for Uxbridge. This one is a three-part question. I believe, yep, it is, okay. And similar to the last question, the subject is rice. Rice indeed. And I'll give you three definitions and you will give me the answer. Japanese wine made from rice is called this. Brown rice includes vitamin B1, which is also called this. And what's the term for unmilled rice or Asian rice fields? So Japanese wine is made from this. Brown rice includes vitamin B1, which is also called what? And what's the term for unmilled rice or Asian rice fields? Ish. Okay, what do you guys got?
For the first one, we had sake.
That is correct.
The second, we had beta carotene.
That is incorrect.
The third, we had rice patties.
That is correct. So 20 points, 10 and 10 for Uxbridge. Nice job, 2 out of 3. I'm going to catch up here on my note-taking. Okay, we are back to a toss-up question. Ms. Grimshaw, can we get a time just to see where we are overall?
13 minutes.
13 minutes left or in?
Left.
13 minutes left. Okay, so we're just past halfway. Score currently Uxbridge 30, Lester 60. Here we go with the next toss-up question. Again, this is both teams. The Swedes brought their own timber with them when they settled in Delaware. What type of building did they introduce? Uxbridge.
Log cabin.
That is correct. Log cabin is correct. Famous for its maple syrup as well. You are up to a four-part bonus question. This will just be Uxbridge. Allow me to get to my four-part page. Okay, here we go. So the subject is six-letter words. The following four terms will be answered by a six-letter word. A, what do we call a person who judges the worth of a piece of literature? B, what governmental term describes a planned meeting between the heads of state of the U.S. and Russia? C, in what simple machine are forces transmitted by ropes used in conjunction with wheels and axles? And D, what is the name for resulting depression when a meteorite strikes the surface of Mars or the Moon? Now I'll repeat those quickly. A critic... Oh, I just gave the answer away.
What is critic?
I apologize. Governmental term that describes a planned meeting between the Soviets and the United States. A simple machine. Forces transmitted by ropes in conjunction with wheels and axles. The name for resulting depression when a meteorite strikes the surface of Mars. Those are your three. And I'm going to give them critic. I just feel like I should. So you get 10 points for critic.
What? No.
Hey.
That is
how
it works. They avoid the answer.
Agreed.
Agreed.
That's a good thing.
You get the second one?
10 seconds.
Okay. You ready?
Yep, can I have an answer, please?
Critic?
Hey, how about that?
Meeting?
Meeting?
Holy?
Okay.
And crater.
Okay. Meeting was incorrect. The answer is summit. Pulley and crater are both correct. Good job on that question. So a total of 30, Reese, on those. Okay, we're back to a toss-up question. What mythical Scottish town appears for one day every 100 years? Lester.
Transylvania.
And that is incorrect.
Scottish town?
Uxbridge. Go ahead.
Tylerville.
That is incorrect. The correct answer is Brigadoon. He said as if he knew. Okay, toss-up question. What president was known as, quote, the most spirited bench warmer, unquote, when he played football at Whittier College? Uxbridge.
Gerald Ford.
That is incorrect. Lester. The most spirited bench warmer.
Richard Nixon.
That is correct. Okay, we are back to a 2-point bonus question for Lester. Okay, so I will explain it prosaically. It should be pretty good because I don't know what that word means. And for you will recite the proverb. I will explain it prosaically and you recite the proverb. This is a 2-part question. Doing something over and over makes one better at it. And do yourself what you advise others to do. So A is doing something over and over makes one better at it, and B is do yourself what you advise others to do. Yeah. 15 seconds.
Sure.
5 seconds. You appear to be ready.
Practice makes perfect, and do unto others as you want others to do unto you.
Good guess. The first one is correct. Practice does indeed make perfect. The second one is practice what you preach. So 10 points on that bonus. Okay, we are back to the toss-up, both teams.
8 minutes left, Mr.
Gershon. 8 minutes left, okay. A Foucault's pendulum proves that the Earth rotates. What apparent force causes it to move its plane of oscillation? Lester.
Gravity.
That is incorrect. Oxbridge? Go ahead.
Centripetal force.
Excellent, correct. Glad you picked the other one. That was hard to read. Hot mic. Okay, bonus question for Uxbridge is a 3-part question. And the subject is love. Three parts. Name the author of, quote, The Love Song of J. Alfred Prufrock. B. Identify the city of brotherly love. C. Name Shakespeare's play beginning with the words loves. So you're naming the author of The Love Song of J. Alfred Prufrock. You're identifying the city of brotherly love, and you are naming Shakespeare's play that begins with the word loves. 20 seconds.
Okay.
10 seconds. How about it, sir?
The first one is Thoreau, the second, Philadelphia, and the third, Romeo and Juliet.
Okay, the first is incorrect, it's T.S. Eliot. The second is Philadelphia, that is correct. And the third one was Love's Labor's Lost, so that is incorrect. So 10 points on the bonus question for Uxbridge. Moving right along, back to the toss-up questions. Both teams play. Find the Druid of... we're skipping that one. That was almost too much like math. Asked to explain the difference between a misfortune and a calamity, the high British official concocted an example concerning his favorite political target. Quote, if Gladstone fell into the Thames, that would be a misfortune. If someone pulled him out, that would be a calamity. Name the wit. It says wit.
You mean the speaker?
Yeah. Lester.
Winston Churchill.
It's a good guess. It is incorrect. Uxbridge. And yes. Asked to explain the difference between a misfortune and a calamity, this high British official concocted an example concerning his favorite political target. If Gladstone fell into the Thames, that would be a misfortune. If someone pulled him out, that would be a calamity. 5 seconds. Need an answer. Benjamin Disraeli. He said, as if he knew. Okay, back to the toss-up questions. By he, I mean me. In only one of the following extremes can the laboratory achieve more than Mother Nature herself. Is it high temperature, lowest temperature, strongest pressure, or highest energy? So of those four, only one of these can be achieved. Lester.
Pressure. High pressure.
Strong pressure is incorrect. Go ahead.
Highest energy.
Highest energy also incorrect. The correct answer is lowest temperature. Man can create conditions 10,000 times cooler than the coldest spot in the universe. Which might be my heart. Couldn't help. All right, next toss-up question. The largest freshwater fish can weigh as much as 2,200 pounds. What is it called? Uxbridge.
Great white shark.
That is incorrect. Carp is also incorrect, but a good guess. Say sturgeon. Okay, moving on. Both teams. May Charlotte's Web best be described as a story of romance, adventure, insects, or friendship? Lester.
Friendship.
Thank God that is correct. Okay, bonus question for Lester. We are up to another four-part question. I believe. Okay. So, four-part question. Again, I'll read the entire question, and you will have 30 seconds to create the complete answer. Translate the following Spanish words into English. Oh, this is a bad choice for me. Machismo. Pronto. Diablo. Aficionado. It's machismo, isn't it? Machismo. M-A-C-H-I-S-M. Pronto, Diablo, Aficionado. Ten seconds.
First one, strong. The second one, now. Third one, devil. And last one, expert.
Okay, so you said strong, now, devil, expert. Okay, devil is correct. I'm asking for a judgment quickly here. The word is virility from machismo. Strong, yes, yay or nay?
No.
No. Pronto is wrong. That would be quickly, not now. And then the last one, you said expert? The answer is enthusiast or devotee? 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 What do we think? I agree with strong. That one's not the same. Expert, I think, applies. There you go. Give the expert. So 20 points total for devil and expert. Okay, we are back to the toss-up questions. Here we go. Both teams.
1 minute.
Originally referring to a hood worn by the canon of a cathedral, this word also applies to a game in which the pieces are sometimes called bones. But it also... Uxbridge.
Dominoes.
Dominoes is correct. All right, you're up to a... So, Uxbridge has a two-part bonus question. And the subject is punishment. First question. This is a settlement outside a country where the country sends its prisoners. And this famous French penal colony was started by Napoleon III in 1852. Name it.
Could you say the word before colony?
Penal colony.
Can you repeat the second?
This famous French penal colony was started by Napoleon III in 1852. 5 seconds. Okay, we need an answer.
First one is exile.
Okay, second?
The second one is the Island of Misfit Toys.
I wish I'd give creative points. Unfortunately, both incorrect. The first answer is a penal colony, which is strange that the second part of it actually says that, and the second one is Devil's Island. Yeah, no, it really is. This settlement outside a country where the country sends its prisoners is a penal colony, and then the second clue is a French penal colony. Strange. All right, are we on time? Is that it?
Yeah.
All right. Tight game. Lester wins 110-100. That was a really good match. 10 points. I'll give a quick refresh to the rules, as they have slightly changed. So Milbury to my left, and Lester to my right. Again, a 30-minute match between these two teams. The toss-up question is to be answered by only one person from each team. The toss-up question is answered correctly, then that team will then get the bonus question, which then can be answered by several. They will confer, and I'll ask the question. You'll provide me with the final answer at that time, after the time has elapsed, or you're ready. We are out of two-part bonus questions, so each one will be a 3 or a 4, and they will go consecutively, I believe is the word. And that's pretty much it. No conferring on the toss-up. Bonus as you can. And we have 30 seconds-ish for bonus questions and 10 seconds to answer the toss-ups. We good to go?
Yep.
All right, seasoned veterans up here. Milbury versus Lester. Let's begin.
Go 14.
Okay. First toss-up question for both teams. What are the important Iranian Muslim clergymen called? Important Iranian Muslim clergyman. 5 seconds. Time is up. Correct answer is Ayatollahs. As said, yes. And repeated. Next toss-up question. What city had North America's first medical school, bank, and city-paid police force? Lester.
Boston.
Boston is incorrect. Milbury. Go ahead.
Baltimore.
Baltimore also incorrect. Both good guesses. The correct answer is Philadelphia. It's the second Philadelphia question. This guy must be from Philadelphia. The next toss-up question. Both teams. The Danube River ends in the Black Sea. In what forest does it begin? The Danube River ends in the Black Sea. In what forest does it begin?
3. The Black Forest.
That is correct. Black Forest is correct. You're on the board.
Yes, please.
Has anybody on this team been there? Okay. All right, your bonus question, Milbury. The first of the match is a 3-part question. As discussed, again, you will have 30 seconds from when I finish, and you guys can confer, and I'll ask for an answer. The subject is science. In the human, shock is characterized by a dangerous reduction in the flow of what? That's A. B, in biology, what classification is lower than an order, yet higher than a genus? B, C, in physics, what is the opposite of a conductor? And I'll repeat if necessary. You have. In biology, what classification is lower than an order and higher than a genus? 20 seconds. Okay, we need an answer.
For the first one, electrolytes. The second one, family. And the third one, insulator.
Second and third are correct. Family and insulator. The first one is incorrect. It was blood. 2 out of 3. Great job. Okay, so a total of... 30 for the one. Okay. All right, here we go. Back to the toss of both teams. Suppose that you were on a basketball team. The guards weigh 163 pounds and 149 pounds. The forwards weigh 144 pounds and 178 pounds. How much does the center weigh if the average weight of the players is 156 pounds? Correct. Should not be talking, Lester. 10 seconds. Go ahead.
250 pounds.
That is incorrect, Milbury.
Good try.
132.
That is close. The correct answer is 146. I had absolutely no idea. All right, next toss-up question. Quick update, Milbury 30, Lester not 30. The name is familiar in both, the name is familiar in both Chicago and Detroit. Chicago was built on the site of a fort by this name and has a street by that name. The namesake is a suburb of Detroit. All were named for the same person. What's the name? I'm going to repeat that question. The name is familiar in both Chicago and Detroit. Chicago was built on the site of a fort by this name and has a street by that name. The namesake is a suburb of Detroit, and all were named for the same person. What is that name? 10 seconds. Milbury.
McKinley.
McKinley is incorrect. Lester.
Duquesne.
Duquesne is also incorrect. Correct answer is Dearborn. Duquesne is Pittsburgh. That was a good guess. Toss-up question, both teams. If they bind me fast with new ropes that never were occupied, then shall I be weak and be as another man? Which biblical hero said this? Lester.
Moses.
Moses is incorrect. Milbury? Go ahead.
Jedediah.
Jedediah is incorrect. That's an awesome name. Okay, back to the toss-ups. Oh, I apologize. It's correct answer is Samson. It's Jedediah's cousin. Okay, toss-up question. Name the well-respected comedian who once said, quote, "I went to a fight last night and a hockey game broke out." Lester.
Yogi Berra.
That is incorrect. Milbury? Go ahead.
David Blaine.
David Blaine is incorrect. Correct answer is Rodney Dangerfield. Toss-up question, both teams. Name the East Coast city that's home base to the Atlantic Fleet of the U.S. Navy. Milbury.
What is Annapolis?
That is incorrect. Lester. 5 seconds. Need an answer.
Norfolk.
One more time.
Norfolk.
Norfolk is correct.
Let's go. Let's go.
Okay, Lester is up for a 4-point question. A four-part question. You can confirm this one, as you know.
Okay.
For 10 points each, find the word in each group that does not belong with the other four. This reminds me of Sesame Street, which I watched this morning. First one is quadrangle, pentagon, fivefold, quintuple, pentathlon. Second one is piccolo, viola, cello, bass violin, violin. Third one is power, potency, strength, validity, efficiency.
What was the last one?
Efficiency. I think I'm getting paid. And the fourth one is Wounded Knee, Black Hawk, Alamo, Tippecanoe, Little Bighorn. You're on the clock. I can repeat if necessary.
Can you repeat the last one?
The last one is Wounded Knee, Black Hawk, Alamo, Tippecanoe, Little Bighorn. Third one is power, potency, strength, validity, efficacy. I am murdering that last word. Quadrangle, pentagon, fivefold, quintuple, pentathlon. You guys need an answer in 5 seconds.
Okay.
All right, here we go.
Quadrangle, piccolo, validity, and Alamo.
Wow, you got all four correct.
Yeah.
Well done. Later on, you guys can tell me what that FSC word is, because I didn't know that. All right, back to the toss-up questions. Both teams play. Lester 50, Milbury 30. What painter gave his name to a collar, a shade of brown, and best of all, a short, pointed beard? All three of these were often seen in his portraits. Milbury.
Goatee.
Good guess. Not correct. Lester.
Wait.
Go ahead.
Picasso.
Picasso, also incorrect. The painter's name is Anthony Van Dyck. Next toss-up question. This famous religious leader, Martin Luther, lived to be 63 years old. Name any one year in which he lived.
You gotta fix up.
Sorry, my bad. So, famous religious leader Martin Luther lived to be 63. Name any one year in which he lived. Lester.
1595.
Incorrect. Milbury. Go ahead.
27.
You guys, you're incorrect, but you're both, like, not incorrect by a lot. 1483 to 1546. That's pretty good. All right, next toss-up question. Which Archbishop of Canterbury pronounced Henry VIII's divorce of Catherine of Aragon valid and was later burned at the stake by Queen Mary?
So what's the question?
Which Archbishop of Canterbury did those things? Go ahead.
Alexander.
Is he like Prince? He's got one name. That is incorrect. Milbury. Yeah, okay, the correct answer is Thomas Cranmer. Okay, next toss-up question. Which of F. Scott Fitzgerald's novels tells the story of an American psychiatrist whose marriage to a beautiful mental patient eventually costs him his career? Five seconds. Lester?
The Great Gatsby.
Great Gatsby is incorrect. Milbury. Go ahead.
Beautiful Mind.
Beautiful Mind is also incorrect. Correct answer is Tender is the Night. Okay, next toss-up question. Math question. If 2 and 162 are the first and fifth terms of a geometric progression, what are the second, third, and fourth terms? You can hear the pencils dropping in frustration. If 2 and 162 are the first and fifth terms of a geometric progression, what are the second, third, and fourth terms? 5 seconds. Time. Time's up. The answer is 6, 18, and 54. Okay, next toss-up. It's been a while. Despondency adores companionship. What popular proverb says it better? Despondency adores companionship. What popular proverb says this better? Five seconds. Time is up. Misery loves company. Kind of like being in this program. Toss-up question. What was the first occupation mentioned in the Bible? Milbury.
A carpenter.
Good guess. That is incorrect. Lester. Go ahead.
A fisherman.
Also a good guess. Also incorrect. The correct answer is shepherd. Okay, moving on. Toss-up question. Both teams. And I'll quickly remind both teams that toss-up questions are one person and one person only. No conferring on those. Here we go. On what topic did Victoria Woodhull, the first woman to address Congress, speak? Milbury.
Women's suffrage.
Correct. And we are looking for, I believe, a three-part question this time, right? It's been a while. Okay, three-part question for Milbury again. I will take the final answer after time. The subject is semi, S-E-M-I, semi. And the first is, a happening twice a year is called what? A. B. A publication every 2 weeks is called what? C. The 50th anniversary is called what? So happening twice a year, a publication every 2 weeks, and the 50th anniversary of something. You have 20 seconds.
Could you repeat the third one, please?
I can. 50th anniversary is called what? Need an answer? 5 seconds.
Am I reading? Okay. The first one is semi-annual. The second one is bi-weekly. And the third one is half a century.
Okay, the first one you are correct, semi-annual. The second one is semi-monthly, and the third one is semi-centennial. So 10 points for the first one that was correct. Again, all answers had to contain semi. All right, toss-up question. And we have a ball game again. Fantastic. What do we got for time left?
15 minutes.
Wow. Halfway through, tied, knotted, they say, at 50. Toss-up question. What state contains the principal headwaters of the Missouri River? What state contains the principal headwaters of the Missouri River? Milbury.
What is Minnesota?
Minnesota is incorrect. Lester?
Missouri.
Missouri is also incorrect. The correct answer is Montana. Okay. Next toss-up question. This one's a little lengthy. I'll be quick if I can. What was the connection between an English science fiction writer, a German philosopher, a German composer, and a computer called HAL? Include identifications of these people in your answer. And this is a toss-up question.
Can you read it again?
I can. What is the connection between an English science fiction writer, a German philosopher, a German composer, and a computer called HAL? You also need to include identifications of these people in your answer. Five seconds. Go ahead.
Were they all named Wells?
That is incorrect. Milbury? Yeah, that's a tough one. Okay, so it's Arthur Clarke is the author who wrote 2001 A Space Odyssey, featuring the computer HAL, for the film version of which the theme music was the opening fanfare from also Sprach Zarathustra, a tone poem by the German composer Richard Strauss. based on the book by Nietzsche. Wow, that's a lot of angry German names. Okay, toss-up question. What word? Is that a mistake? That's okay. I don't think you're ready for what word. We can live with that one. What word describes the storage area in an airplane, a body of water? Milbury.
Cargo.
Cargo is incorrect. Lester, rest of the question. The storage area in an airplane, a body of water, and the bark of a hound. Go ahead.
Howl.
Howl is incorrect. There is a bay in an airplane. I don't think there's a howl in an airplane. Right, so toss-up question. Bay. Yeah, this is a bay airplane. Which president, before 1850, regarding his powers as autonomous, declared the following: the executive must be guided by his own opinion of the Constitution. Lester.
Thomas Jefferson.
Incorrect. Milbury. Go ahead.
Andrew Jackson.
That is correct, Andrew Jackson. No. Nice job. Dave, you knew it all along. Come on.
Yes, Reese.
Okay, we are up to a 4-part question, bonus question for Milbury, and it is as follows. These four answers will start with the letter E. Start with the letter E. A, name the capital of a Canadian province. B, give the term for a disease that spreads rapidly. C, in ancient times, the Ptolemy dynasty ruled which country? And D, name the U.S. Cabinet Department formerly headed by William Bennett. I'll repeat if necessary. You have 20 seconds.
What was the third one?
In ancient times, the Ptolemy dynasty ruled which country? Ten seconds.
What was the last one?
Name the U.S. Cabinet Department formerly headed by William Bennett. And I'll need an answer.
The first one is Edmonton. The second one is Epidemic. The third one is Ethiopia. And the fourth one is Executive.
Okay, first two are correct. It is indeed Edmonton and Epidemic. The third one is Egypt, and the fourth one was Education. Edumacation. So, 20 points on the bonus. Okay, moving on. Back to a toss-up question. Both teams are playing. What is the process called in metallurgy of extracting metal from ore by heating it in a blast furnace? Lester.
Smelting.
Smelting is correct.
Let's go. Yes, Chris. Yes.
Three-part question. Three-part question for Lester. The subject, James K. Polk. All right, part A. Polk declared war on what country during his presidency? B, the Polk Doctrine forbidding European colonization on American soil expanded the doctrine of what former president? And C, the Democrats nominated Polk over what former president? I'll repeat as necessary. You have 20 seconds. Polk Doctrine forbidding European colonization, on American soil expanded the doctrine of what former president?
In the third one, please.
The Democrats nominated Polk over what former president? 5 seconds.
Okay. Yes. The first one is Mexico. Second one is the Monroe Doctrine. And the third one is Tiger.
First two are correct. Mexico, indeed. Monroe, indeed. The third one is Martin Van Buren. Nice job. 2 out of 3 is not so bad there. Okay, back to the toss-up questions. We have 80 to 80. You guys are battling back and forth. Here we go. Time check.
Eight minutes.
All right. Toss-up question. What is another name for a post-mortem examination? Milbury.
Autopsy.
Autopsy is correct. All right, you guys get the 4-point question. For 10 points apiece, answer these questions about the origins of states' names. A, what Algonquin word for warriors gave Illinois its state name? B, what state bears the name of an imaginary paradise in a 1510 Spanish romance novel? C, who gave Virginia its name in honor of the Virgin Queen Elizabeth? And D, what fraudulent Indian word meaning gem of the mountains gave this state its nickname of the Gem State? And I'll repeat as necessary, 20 seconds.
The second one is Florida, and that's how we got it.
I appreciate that efficient answer.
Thank you.
I like that. The second one is actually California, but I appreciate it. And I say that as if I knew. I had no idea. Illinois is the first answer. The second answer is California. The third answer is Sir Walter Raleigh. And the fourth answer is Idaho. I did not know Idaho was a gem state. Sorry, Idahoans. I didn't know how to say that. Toss-up question. Both teams, give me the title of the most famous piece from Mendelssohn's Midsummer Night's Dream. Yeah, that answer is the... Lester!
Hawk's Soliloquy.
Ah, nice guess. That is incorrect. Milbury! Most famous piece from Mendelssohn's Midsummer Night's Dream. Go ahead.
Syllogism.
It's the Wedding March. Close. All right, next question. Toss up. Translate wise man, quote, wise man, unquote, into Latin to get a well-known biological term. If you translate wise man into Latin, you will get a well-known biological term. What is that term? Five seconds. Milbury.
Cranium.
Cranium is incorrect. Lester?
We'll pass.
Pass? Incorrect. The correct answer is Homo sapiens. Toss-up question. Guinevere, Gawain, and Galahad were members of whose court? Lester.
King Arthur.
That is correct. King Arthur's court. You guys are back on for a three-part question. For 10 points each, all of the following answers will start with the letter U, and you can confirm this question. They start with the letter U. A, only a virgin may capture this mythical animal. B, what element was named for a 1781 celestial discovery? And C, what historic Irish province contains all of Northern Ireland plus three counties of the Republic of Ireland? 20 seconds, I'll repeat if necessary.
First one.
Only a virgin may capture this mythical animal. The last one is, what historic Irish province contains all of Northern Ireland plus three counties of the Republic of Ireland?
Okay.
So,
5 seconds.
Okay. Unicorn, uranium, and United Kingdom.
Wow. First two are correct. Good job with those. Unicorn and uranium correct. The third one is Ulster. Okay. Shucking and jiving. Both sides, both teams playing. The powdered seed of a carrot relative has a fragrance and taste resembling licorice. Name the spice. Milbury.
Anise.
Anise is correct. You guys are on for a four-part question. Anise. Call that close enough. Okay, four-part question. For 10 points each, the answer starts with white. Quote, white, unquote. A, it has a red room, a green room, a blue room, and an east room. B, it's an untruth told to spare someone's feelings. C, you might use one of these as a Christmas tree. And D, an official cover-up of an influential person's vices or crimes. 20 seconds, I'll repeat as necessary.
Can you repeat the last one?
An official cover-up of an influential person's vices or crimes. Ten seconds. Five seconds.
The first one's White House.
Okay.
The second one's White Lodge.
Okay.
Third is White Pine.
Okay. The last one was Whitewash, but you did get 3 out of 4, so well done there. So 30 points for Milbury. All right. Toss-up question. Name the Lexington, Virginia University nicknamed the Generals. Milbury.
Virginia Tech.
Incorrect. Lester.
Are you allowed to repeat it?
Name the Lexington, Virginia University nicknamed the Generals. Go ahead.
University of Virginia.
That is incorrect. Correct answer is Washington and Lee. Next toss-up question. How many walls can a good serve hit before bouncing in racquetball? Lester.
2.
Correct answer is 2. Yes. Lester.
Yes.
3-part question.
Oh, yeah.
Yes. Oh, 1 minute.
Okay, 3-part question. Here we go. Subject is music. A, what Spanish name is given to the open-air evening music that is often performed by a gentleman in tribute to his lady? B, what musical term is defined as a short blast of trumpets to introduce some special event or ceremony? C, name the stick used by a musical conductor. I will repeat as necessary of 20 seconds. Second one is, what musical term is defined as a short blast of trumpets to introduce a special event or ceremony? 10 seconds.
Okay, but we don't know.
5 seconds.
Alright, so our first one is serenade.
Okay.
Second one is introduction.
Okay.
And third one is baton.
You got 1 and 3 correct. Second one is fanfare. 20 points. Okay, we have another, we have time for another toss-up. Here we go.
No, time is ended.
Oh. That wasn't intentional. I swear it wasn't intentional. Just for funsies. No, there'll be no funsies.
Yes.
All right, Lester with a last-minute victory. That concludes the Honor Bowl. Thank you all for attending.